My name's Martin Campbell and I'm the director of GOLDENEYE. Ian Sharp was my second unit director. You know, I'd worked with him on The Professionals many years ago. In England, people will recognise that TV show. Obviously, they won't in the States, but we both came up through one-hour television series. And Ian subsequently went on to direct a movie called Who Dares Wins. And I asked him to do the job simply because he was an A-list director, and that's what I wanted. I didn't want a second unit director who was also doing the stunts. And thank God I asked him, because he was really terrific. He did a lot of the car chase and the early sequence. He shot the sequence on the dam. He shot an awful lot of the tank chase, which was a combination of Leningrad and the studio lot. We built a lot of those streets on the back lot. It was the only way we could control it. So a good second unit director was absolutely essential in this case, and I was very fortunate to have him.
It's about one of the most exciting parts of this particular scene. Bond steals a tank, comes smashing through a wall and pursues the tank through the streets of St. Petersburg. And in this stage, what we're setting up for now is where the tank's going to smash through this Perrier truck. The truck has been pre-cut in various sections and is also loaded with some with water, some empty cans. The special effects department have also put charges on some of the cans, so you'll see the cans explode out of the truck and the tank come charging through, splitting the truck completely into and on its merry way before it goes on and eventually smashes through the statue here and carries that away on its back. We have had some great stuff to do. I mean, this is a great train set to play with. You know, this is real. This is Toys R Us, you know, all the with a street and tanks and statues and trucks. I mean, it's every boy's dream, you know. Everything's been pre-cut, ready to, so that the whole, that both sides will fly out. We've no idea where they're going to go, but seems to be, just about every shot on this picture seems to be like that. We're working in completely unknown territory because none of us have ever, even with all the experience of many members of the crew here on big action movies, nobody's actually done a tank chase before, so just about every shot's a new experience. Like yesterday, the tank managed to go, instead of going through the wall down the alleyway, managed to go over a Panavision camera and finished up like an oil painting on the deck. So everyone brings a surprise. We'll also be doing a shot of the driver to show that he's okay. It's quite important on this that this is a fun chase. Yes, he responsibly hits the Perrier truck. We've got a second one up our sleeve, but hopefully this will work first time. It's certainly only one go at it, but we do have a second truck which is already being in the process of being pre-cut and ready to take to in case this is a complete disaster. The reasons for splitting the two between location and here are to get as much as we can out of the background in Russia without creating too much havoc. And then we come here and under more controlled conditions we can reconstruct the street. You see the tank coming down the street, weaving through the traffic, cut round here, Perrier truck, bang, out comes the tank out the other side, we hope. To about 50 miles an hour, I think, yeah. Between 40 and 50 anyway, when it's really motoring. It's going to take a long run at this. He's starting somewhere in Watford, I think, to get up into the 11th gear to really smash this truck, and so obviously we've had to move everything in front so to give him time to come to a halt. Otherwise he could well finish up the other side of Hertfordshire.
Thank you.
Well done, chaps.
Gary, you okay?
The Atlantic, they're going to be saying, how are we going to top that?